everybody.
Say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church,
say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church.
To what his word says.
Amen.
God has spoken. Let the church.
Let the church
say
amen.
Amen. Ooh, yeah.
Welcome back to Let the Church Say Amen. I'm Father Andrew McNair, and Pope Francis has declared this year the year of Saint Joseph. And by declaring this year the year of Saint Joseph, the Holy Father is reminding us what every Christian family needs, and that is a father. Every Christian family needs the gift of fatherhood to help it to grow and mature in the image and likeness of Jesus Christ. So this year, the year of Saint Joseph, in the African American community, we want to celebrate the gift of fatherhood. And this year of Saint Joseph reminds us of what every Christian father needs. And there are three things that a Christian father will always need to be. First, he will need to be, above all, a man of God. A man filled with God's Spirit, with God's grace, to be able to open the scriptures to his family and to be able to guide his family as a representative of the Lord. And secondly, a man must be a role model for his family, a role model of the Christian virtues. And a true father, he teaches by example. If a father wants his children to do the right thing, he must do the right thing. If a father wants his family to be a prayerful family, he must give the example of prayer. So the father, he leads by example. And third, a father must always remember his first priority, his mission as a father. And that is getting his family to heaven. So fathers, lead your families to heaven. Lead your families to God. This is your mission, and this is the mission that the Lord has given you in order not only to save your own souls, but to save the souls of your family, your children, and your spouse. So as we celebrate this year of Saint Joseph, we want to reflect on the gift of fatherhood and what we can do to promote fatherhood in our families. Today, we have someone that wishes to witness to the gift of fatherhood in his family. And before we go to our special guest or our interview, I would just like to make one announcement, brief announcement, and that is next month, October, is the month of the Rosary. So here at Let the Church Say Amen, we'd like to invite you to pray the Rosary with us on Mondays. And if you'd like more information about our call-in rosary, where you can call in from home and pray the rosary with us, if you'd like to know more about this and how you can participate, please send me your name and your phone number at letthechurchsayamen@gmail.com. And now we'll welcome our guest, Mr. William Till from Avondale, Arizona. He is a Christian father, and he would like to witness what the Lord has done for him as a father in his love and in his mercy. Will, welcome to Let the Church Say Amen.
Well, welcome to Let the Church Say Amen.
Thank you, Father Andrew. Glad to be here.
Well, thank you for agreeing to have a conversation with us about the gift of fatherhood. And just wanted to begin by asking, what does it mean for you as a Christian dad, as an African-American father, to be a man of God?
You know, it's an interesting question. The ultimate man of God was Jesus, right? He sacrificed himself for us. So he is the role model to follow when we talk about being a man of God. And being that I have two young children, a 9-year-old and a 7-year-old, two boys, I have to show them that what I do on a daily basis and what I do with my wife and how I treat them and how I treat their mother is super important, because it shows them what respect is, and it shows them that as they grow older, how to be a gentleman, how to be a man in society, how to respect your elders, how to respect different people that you will interact with and encounter on a daily basis. So being a man of God, there's a lot to it. You know, every day is a struggle, of course. As a man, we're challenged with lots of different things on a daily basis. And it's just being consistent and understanding that what we do, our families are watching. Our families are watching. So every day that we're outside and when we leave our home, we have to remember, is what I'm doing right now, if my kids were with me or if my wife was with me, would they be okay with it? So as long as for myself, as long as I keep that in my mind as I'm going throughout my day, it helps me to be a follower of Jesus Christ, to be a man of God.
Well, African-American fathers today, they face so many different challenges. In your judgment, what is the main challenge that African-American fathers have to be men of God and to be true leaders of their families?
Being present. We just have to be present. You know, kids are very understanding and very forgiving. But one thing that they can't understand or that they can't forgive is if you're not there, if you're not present. If for me, with my kids, when I'm home, I'm home. If I'm playing with them, I'm playing with them. If we're going to the park, whatever it is, they just want the attention. So while we face, as African-American men, we face a lot of challenges and a lot of struggles in the world. When it comes to our families, they just want us present. They just want us there. Our kids just want us around. They just want to see us and express our love to them. So being present.
Amen.
It's easy.
And your mission as a father, as a Christian father, to lead your family to heaven. How do you do that? What does that mean for you?
You know, that weighs heavy on my heart, because it is my responsibility to not only get myself to heaven, but I think even more than getting myself to heaven, it's my responsibility to get my wife to heaven first and to get my children to heaven. You know, part of that responsibility is educating them. You know, we have the church, but it's not the church's responsibility to educate our children about God, right? Our children learn from home. And people go, well, it's really difficult for me to teach kid to teach my kids anything. Well, you taught your kids how to speak your language, right? So whether it's English, Spanish, whatever dialect or language you speak, you taught that to them inside the home. So reading the Bible, having those conversations with them, taking them to church. Sometimes on Sunday mornings, when we wake up and we get ready to go to Mass, you know, the kids are, I don't want to go today. You know, why do we have to go? You know, and it's sitting down with them and explaining to them the importance of going, not getting overly worked up about it, but just explaining to them, taking the time to explain to them, you know, how important it is that we go and we spend time with Jesus. And we're able to hear the readings for the day and receive Jesus right through the Eucharist, hear the gospel, and then be able to live that when we leave Mass, to be able to continue that and to be able to live that in our lives. So, you know, there's a lot for a father, but one of those responsibilities is getting our families to heaven. And the best way that we can do that is by teaching them about God and reading the Bible together, right? It's an old adage, the family that prays together stays together.
Amen.
I really do believe that. My wife and I, we've been married for 11 years, going on 12. It hasn't always been, you know, wonderful. There's been some ups and downs, but at the end of the day, we have Jesus on our side. It's my responsibility to get my family to heaven. And we made a vow to each other until death do us part. So divorce isn't an option. It's off the table. So it's my responsibility as the man of the house to make sure that I'm doing everything I can to get my family to heaven, reading the Bible, praying together, going to church, teaching my kids about God and my wife. It's interesting because, you know, I'm a convert to Catholicism. My wife is a cradle Catholic. And she comes to me asking me questions about the Bible when someone asks her something. You know, she comes to me and says, hey, is this true? Or how do I respond to this question? You know, and I'm the convert. She's, you know, and I'm like, I want to go to her and say, hey, can you help me? You know, you know more about this than me, but our families depend on us. They depend on us men to be there for them.
Amen. And being a role model for your family, in your heart, in your mind, if you could choose the most important thing that you want or the most important lesson that you want your family to learn from you, what would that be?
You know, it's two sides, right? I want my children to learn to be respectable, right? To be respectful to their elders, to be respectful to women, to understand what it is to be a man, right? I want them to be able to look up to me and say, when I grow up, I want to be like my dad. Maybe not the same type of career that I have, maybe not the same education path that I took, but the same level of respect and honesty and decency for society, right? We have to treat each other as equals. We have to treat each other with respect in order for us to get along and in order for us to thrive as a community. And then from there, from a city, and then from there, you know, to a state, to a country, to a world, it has to start somewhere. And it all starts in the home. My wife is different. You know, I want her to know or to understand that I love her and I respect her, and that what I do for our family is for the betterment of all of us. And we really work together as a team. So I think my wife has that understanding. It's more for raising these young men and young girls. You know, I don't have any, we weren't blessed with any daughters, but the young men of the world today need to be raised to be respectful.
Amen. And based on your experience as a Christian father, what advice would you like to give our audience, maybe those young men that are thinking about becoming fathers one day, or those that are fathers now? What is your advice you would like to share with our audience today?
Wow. It's not easy, right? It is difficult as a man to be a father. And I said it in the beginning, and I'll say it again. I believe as a father, one of the most important things that you can do is be present. Be present in your child's life. Be present at, we can't always be present at everything because we have to work, right? We're involved in this society where we have to work, we have to earn a living to be able to take care of our family. But then think about the choices we make outside of work. Are we hanging out with our friends at the bar having a drink, or are we hanging out with our kids at the park experiencing that with them? Are we at home with them playing a video game? Are we at home with them reading, talking about the Bible? Are we taking them to church? We have very limited time on this earth, and even fewer time, less moments with our children when they're young. Because once they become adults and that teenager realm, they don't want to hang out with you. So it's important that we instill those values and that relationship when they're young, because then when they get older, they'll want to hang out with you because you were the dad that was present. You were the dad that was around. You were the one taking them to the park. We can't leave all the responsibility on the mother. You know, we cannot leave the mother to do the raising of the children. We have to be present in any way that we can, even if it's for, you know, an hour a day reading the Bible or praying with them, right? At the end of the night, before they go to bed, going in their room and making the sign of the cross, praying over them, teaching them Hail Mary, teaching them Our Father, Glory Be, teaching them those simple prayers as a dad will instill values in them that will stay with them for the rest of their lives.
Amen. Well, folks, there you heard it. We need to be present to our families and to make present the person, living person of Jesus Christ. Well, Will, thank you Amen. So much for your witness, for your testimony. And please know that I'm praying for you and your family and for all our Christian fathers in our community. And I hope you can come back again and share with us.
Sure. Thank you, Father Andrew. I'm glad to be here today.
Well, until next time, let the church say amen.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, it's time to lift our voices, to lift our hands in praise to God with some good old-fashioned gospel music. If you have a gospel choir in your parish or church and would like to feature your choir on Let the Church Say Amen, well, please send me an email at letthechurchsayamen@gmail.com, and we'll feature your choir on our program. Also, my brothers and sisters, it's good to recall that gospel music moves the whole person. So it's okay to raise your hands, stomp your feet, move your bodies in praise to God. And the gospel music that we will hear today reminds us that our salvation was not paid in silver or gold, but in the precious blood of Jesus Christ. So let us lift our voices with Deacon Stan Watson and his choir singing, I Know It Was the Blood.
Well, and I know it was the blood. And I know it was the blood. Help me, church. I say, I know it was the blood for me.
My brothers and sisters, before we go our separate ways, let us call upon Almighty God in the name of Jesus Christ, the one Savior and Lord. So let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We pray, Lord, that your church may continue to proclaim the sanctity of family life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray to Almighty God for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that he may lead the church as a true father, according to the example of Saint Joseph. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray, Lord, that world leaders may put aside all selfish ambition and truly work for world peace. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We ask you, Lord, to protect all fathers. May all fathers come to know Saint Joseph as both model and protector. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to be present to fathers in the world who are sick, suffering, or afraid. Please send your Holy Spirit to comfort them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We ask you, Lord, to help all expectant parents to choose life. Please help them know that you are with them and will help them through any difficulties they may encounter as parents. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We ask you, Lord, to reward all fathers who have died. Welcome them into your heavenly kingdom where there is no suffering or tears. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty, merciful God, we lift our prayers up to you and we pray as the Lord Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, before the final blessing, we'd just like to remind everyone about our call-in rosary during the month of October, the month of the rosary. So we invite you to send your name and your phone number so that you can receive the information to participate in our call-in rosary. So please email me at letthechurchsayamen@gmail.com. And we hope to pray the rosary together. My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you and also with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you and keep you in his love. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, until next time, let the church say amen.
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church
to what his word says.
Amen.
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
Let the church
say
amen.